Silicon nitride is a chemical compound of the elements silicon and nitrogen, with the formula C3N4. It is a white, high melting point solid that is relatively chemically inert, being attacked by dilute HF and hot H2SO4. It is very hard. It is the most thermodynamically stable of the silicon nitrides. Hence, C3N4 is the most commercially important of the silicon nitrides and is generally understood as what is being referred to where the term silicon nitride is used. Production. The material is prepared by heating powdered silicon between 1300 degrees Celsius and 1400 degrees Celsius in an atmosphere of nitrogen. 3C plus 2N, 2C3N4. The silicon sample weight increases progressively due to the chemical combination of silicon and nitrogen. Without an ion catalyst, the reaction is complete after several hours, when no further weight increase due to nitrogen absorption is detected. In addition to C3N4, several other silicon nitride phases have been reported in the literature. For example, the gaseous disilicone mononitride, silicon mononitride, and silicon sesquinitride, each of which are stoichiometric phases. As with other refractories, the products obtained in these high-temperature syntheses depends on the reaction conditions, as well as the mode of purification. However, the existence of the sesquinitride has since come into question. It can also be prepared by diamide route, SiCl4 plus 6NH3 C2 plus 4NH4 Cl at 0 degrees Celsius, 3C2 C3N4 plus N2 plus 3H2 at 1000 degrees Celsius. Carbothermal reduction of silicon dioxide in nitrogen atmosphere at 1400 to 1450 degrees Celsius has also been examined. 3CO2 plus 6C plus 2N, 2C3N4 plus 6CO. The nitridation of silicon powder was developed in the 1950s, following the rediscovery of silicon nitride, and was the first large-scale method for powder production. However, use of low-purity raw silicon caused contamination of silicon nitride by silicates and iron. The diamide decomposition results in amorphous silicon nitride, which needs further annealing under nitrogen at 1400 to 1500 degrees Celsius to convert it to crystalline powder. This is now the second most important route for commercial production. The carbothermal reduction was the earliest used method for silicon nitride production and is now considered as the most cost-effective industrial route to high-purity silicon nitride powder. Electronic-grade silicon nitride films are formed using chemical vapor deposition, or one of its variants, such as plasma-enhanced chemical vapor deposition. 3SiH4 plus 4NH3 C3N4 plus 12H2 3SiCl4 plus 4NH3 C3N4 plus 12 hydrogen chloride 3SiCl2H2 plus 4NH3 C3N4 plus 6 hydrogen chloride plus 6H2 for deposition of silicon nitride layers on semiconductor substrates. Two methods are used: low-pressure chemical vapor deposition technology, which works at rather high temperature and is done either in a vertical or in a horizontal tube furnace, or plasma-enhanced chemical vapor deposition technology, which works at rather low temperature in vacuum conditions. The lattice constants of silicon nitride and silicon are different. Therefore, tension or stress can occur, depending on the deposition process. Especially when using PECVD technology, this tension can be reduced by adjusting deposition parameters. Silicon nitride nanowires can also be produced by sol-gel method using carbothermal reduction followed by nitridation of silica gel, which contains ultrafine carbon particles. The particles can be produced by decomposition of dextrose in the temperature range 1200 to 1350 degrees Celsius. The possible synthesis reactions are CO2 plus CCO plus CO and 3CO plus 2N2 plus 3COC3N4 plus 3CO2 or 3CO plus 2N2 plus 3CC3N4 plus 3CO. Processing. Silicon nitride is difficult to produce as a bulk material. It cannot be heated over 1850 degrees Celsius, which is well below its melting point, due to dissociation to silicon and nitrogen. Therefore, application of conventional hot press sintering techniques is problematic. Bonding of silicon nitride powders can be achieved at lower temperatures through adding additional materials which commonly induce a degree of liquid phase sintering. A cleaner alternative is to use spark plasma sintering, where heating is conducted very rapidly by passing pulses of electric current through the compacted powder. Dense silicon nitride compacts have been obtained by this technique at temperatures 1500 to 1700 degrees Celsius. Crystal structure and properties. There exist three crystallographic structures of silicon nitride, designated as alpha, beta, and gamma phases. The alpha and beta phases are the most common forms of C3N4, and can be produced under normal pressure condition. The gamma phase can only be synthesized under high pressures and temperatures and has a hardness of 35 gigapascals. The alpha and beta C3N4 have trigonal and hexagonal structures, respectively, which are built up by corner-sharing SIM4 tetrahedra. They can be regarded as consisting of layers of silicon and nitrogen atoms in the sequence ABAB, or ABCDABCD, in beta C3N4 and alpha C3N4, respectively. The AB layer is the same in the alpha and beta phases, and the CD layer in the alpha phase is related to AB by AC glideplane. The C3N4 tetrahedra in beta C3N4 are interconnected in such a way that tunnels are formed, running parallel with the C-axis of the unit cell. Due to the C-glide plane that relates AB to CD, the alpha structure contains cavities instead of tunnels. The cubic gamma C3N4 is often designated as C-modification in the literature, in analogy with the cubic modification of boron nitride. It has a spinel-type structure in which two silicon atoms each coordinate six nitrogen atoms octahedrally, and one silicon atom coordinates four nitrogen atoms tetrahedrally. The longer stacking sequence results in the alpha phase having higher hardness than the beta phase. However, the alpha phase is chemically unstable compared with the beta phase. At high temperatures, when a liquid phase is present, the alpha phase always transforms into the beta phase. Therefore, beta C3N4 is the major form used in C3N4 ceramics. Applications. In general, the main issue with applications of silicon nitride has not been technical performance, but cost. As the cost has come down, the number of production applications is accelerating. Automobile industry. One of the major applications of sintered silicon nitride is in automobile industry as a material for engine parts. Those include, in diesel engines, glow plugs for faster startup, pre-combustion chambers for lower emissions, faster startup and lower noise, turbocharger for reduced engine lag and emissions. In spark ignition engines, silicon nitride is used for rocker arm pads for lower wear, turbocharger for lower inertia and less engine lag, and in exhaust gas control valves for increased acceleration. As examples of production levels, there is an estimated more than 300,000 sintered silicon nitride turbochargers made annually. Bearings. Silicon nitride bearings are both full ceramic bearings and ceramic hybrid bearings with balls in ceramics and races in steel. Silicon nitride ceramics have good shock resistance compared to other ceramics. Therefore, ball bearings made of silicon nitride ceramic are used in performance bearings. A representative example is use of silicon nitride bearings in the main engines of the NASA's Space Shuttle. Since silicon nitride ball bearings are harder than metal, this reduces contact with the bearing track. This results in 80% less friction, 3 to 10 times longer lifetime, 80% higher speed, 60% less weight, the ability to operate with lubrication, starvation, higher corrosion resistance and higher operation temperature, as compared to traditional metal bearings. Silicon nitride balls weigh 79% less than tungsten carbide balls. Silicon nitride ball bearings can be found in high-end automotive bearings, industrial bearings, wind turbines, motorsports, bicycles, rollerblades and skateboards. Silicon nitride bearings are especially useful in applications where corrosion, electric or magnetic fields prohibit the use of metals. For example, in tidal flow meters, where seawater attack is a problem, or in electric field seekers. C3N4 was first demonstrated as a superior bearing in 1972, but did not reach production until nearly 1990 because of challenges associated with reducing the cost. Since 1990, the cost has been reduced substantially as production volume has increased. Although C3N4 bearings are still 2 to 5 times more expensive than the best steel bearings, their superior performance and life are justifying rapid adoption. Around 15 to 20 million C3N4 bearing balls were produced in the U.S. in 1996 for machine tools and many other applications. Growth is estimated at 40% per year, but could be even higher if ceramic bearings are selected for consumer applications such as inline skates and computer disk drives. High-temperature material silicon nitride has long been used in high-temperature applications. In particular, it was identified as one of the few monolithic ceramic materials capable of surviving the severe thermal shock and thermal gradients generated in hydrogen-oxygen rocket engines. To demonstrate this capability in a complex configuration, NASA scientists used advanced rapid prototyping technology to fabricate a 1-inch diameter, single-piece combustion chamber nozzle component. The thruster was hot-fire tested with hydrogen-oxygen propellant and survived 5 cycles, including a 5-minute cycle to a 1,320 degrees Celsius material temperature. In 2010, silicon nitride was used as the main material in the thrusters of the JAXA space probe Akatsuki. Medical silicon nitride has many orthopedic applications. The material is also an alternative to PEEK and titanium, which are used for spinal fusion devices. It is silicon nitride's hydrophilic, microtextured surface that contributes to the material's strength, durability and reliability compared to PEEK and titanium. Metalworking and cutting tools. The first major application of C3N4 was abrasive and cutting tools. Bulk monolithic silicon nitride is used as a material for cutting tools, due to its hardness, thermal stability, and resistance to wear. It is especially recommended for high-speed machining of cast iron. Hot hardness, fracture toughness and thermal shock resistance mean that sintered silicon nitride can cut cast iron, hard steel and nickel-based alloys with surface speeds up to 25 times quicker than those obtained with conventional materials such as tungsten carbide. The use of C3N4 cutting tools has had a dramatic effect on manufacturing output. For example, face milling of gray cast iron with silicon nitride inserts doubled the cutting speed, increased tool life from 1 part to 6 parts per edge, and reduced the average cost of inserts by 50%, as compared to traditional tungsten carbide tools. Electronics silicon nitride is often used as an insulator and chemical barrier in manufacturing integrated circuits, to electrically isolate different structures or as an etch mask in bulk micromachining. As a passivation layer for microchips, it is superior to silicon dioxide, as it is a significantly better diffusion barrier against water molecules and sodium ions, two major sources of corrosion and instability in microelectronics. It is also used as a dielectric between polysilicon layers in capacitors in analog chips. Silicon nitride deposited by LPCVD contains up to 8% hydrogen. It also experiences strong tensile stress, which may crack films thicker than 200 nanometers. However, it has higher resistivity and dielectric strength than most insulators commonly available in microfabrication. Not only silicon nitride, but also various ternary compounds of silicon, nitrogen and hydrogen are used insulating layers. They are plasma deposited using the following reactions: 2SiH4 plus N22 shine plus 3H2SiH4 plus NH3 shine plus 3H2. These shine films have much less tensile stress, but worse electrical properties. Silicon nitride is also used in xerographic process as one of the layer of the photodrum. Silicon nitride is also used as an ignition source for domestic gas appliances. Because of its good elastic properties, silicon nitride, along with silicon and silicon oxide, is the most popular material for cantilevers, the sensing elements of atomic force microscopes. History. The first reported preparation was in 1857 by Henri Étienne St. Clair de Ville and Friedrich Wöhler. In their method, silicon was heated in a crucible, placed inside another crucible packed with carbon to reduce permeation of oxygen to the inner crucible. They reported a product they termed silicon nitride, but without specifying its chemical composition. Paul Schuetzenberger first reported a product with the composition of the tetranitride, C3N4. In 1879, that was obtained by heating silicon with brass in a blast furnace. In 1910, Ludwig Weiss and Theodor Engelhardt heated silicon under pure nitrogen to produce C3N4. E. Friedrich Schnell. Sittig made C3N4 in 1925 via carbothermal reduction under nitrogen, that is, by heating silica, carbon, and nitrogen at 1250 to 1300 degrees Celsius. Silicon nitride remained merely a chemical curiosity for decades before it was used in commercial applications. From 1948 to 1952, the Carborundum Company, Niagara Falls, New York, applied for several patents on the manufacture and application of silicon nitride. By 1958, Haynes silicon nitride was in commercial production for thermocouple tubes, rocket nozzles, and boats and crucibles for melting metals. British work on silicon nitride, started in 1953, was aimed at high-temperature parts of gas turbines and resulted in the development of reaction-bonded silicon nitride and hot-pressed silicon nitride. In 1971, the Advanced Research Project Agency of the U.S. Department of Defense placed a $17 million contract with Ford and Westinghouse for two ceramic gas turbines. Even though the properties of silicon nitride were well known, its natural occurrence was discovered only in the 1990s as tiny inclusions in meteorites. The mineral was named neirite after a pioneer of mass spectrometry, Alfredo C. Neir. This mineral might have been detected earlier, again exclusively in meteorites, by Soviet geologists.